Morning.
Morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Hopefully you guys are not still on your bed and like turn off your camera and listen to me like you're like attending your class, okay? It's okay if you haven't showered, just show me your face. Yeah, thank you. Okay, nice. So today is the last day of the conference. How are you feeling?
Excellent.
Nice. You cannot wait to end the conference. I tell you, you're going to miss me. Excellent. Okay, nice. Yep, so today is the last morning plenary that I have with you guys as a chair. And good morning once again. Yeah, of course, you will miss me, but you can still see me in my IG story. Sometimes I post a lot of random stuff about my personal life. Yeah. So in case you find me very inspiring here, maybe you don't find me very inspiring in IG. Yeah. So yes. So before we start, as usual, our request is please rename yourself in case you haven't. And then since today is the last day, if you haven't made many new friends as you want to, don't forget to engage with one another, turn on your cam and chat with me in the chat box. Yep. Nice. Yeah, my IG is my real name, Mei Chen Li. Okay, so we have something very nice from the OC. So thank you, OC team, for the video. So yeah, let's see what is the recap of our conference for the first 2 days. Are you ready for the video?
Yay.
Yep, okay.
So this is the next phase. I don't know how you want to copy this, but okay, you ready? So 3, 2, 1, go! Yeah, wait,
Nice. Thank you, OC, for the video. Can you guys also share some love to the OC in the chat box? If you love them, let them know, because I know they work very hard for this conference, right? So thank you, OC. Love, love. Okay, yeah. Before we start, right, I just want to show off a little bit. I have a fan here supporting me, like next to me right now. Do you want to know who is my fan? Say hi to Isaac in Malaysia.
Hello. Hey, Isaac in Malaysia.
Introduce yourself.
I'm the former MVP of Isaac Cavalier for 2021, and I'm James, my business sister. So, yeah, have a great conference. And
say hello to EJ.
Hello, EJ.
Okay, that's it.
Hello.
Yeah. So just want to show his face in he's accompanying me to do the morning plenary outside because my house has really really bad internet, and he's also the MCP of Isaac Cambodia term 2021, right? Yeah. So yes, you now know another MCP. See. Okay. So I know everyone is still like very sleepy and tired from the 2-day conference, and I know you need a lot of fun as a young people. Like literally everyone's looking forward to this agenda. So can we welcome our fun team?
I like to sing, dance, pretend, and I like to have fun.
Yay! Fun team, woohoo! Do you all like that video? If you all like, then you can say like you like the video. Yeah, I also very like that video. Well, the first time that I heard from the fun team from one of the conference, and then they show this video, and then afterwards I really like this video, and then I will show this video everywhere when I was fun team. Yeah, likey. Okay, thanks. Okay. All right, so yeah, today is the last day of conference, right? Okay, and also it's also your last day to meet the punishment team now, which is Jay and Joe and Sun and Bo. Okay, yeah, you can remember our face out. Okay, yeah, so let's go to the next. So who gets punished today? Yeah, this is also the most exciting part. Okay, I feel actually everyone very bad, you know why? Because whenever people get punished and then you guys laugh at other people, it's not good lah, okay? You have to rescue your friend, right? But no matter how these people are actually get punished lah, because they didn't follow conference rule. So let's go to the next. Yeah, who is Dania? Man, so I don't show, and I'm not sure whether this Dania is here or not. Yeah, so this person play phone lah, okay? And then got people send to me lah, okay? Yeah, I don't know, yeah. That's not the point, okay? That's the point that this person is playing phone. Okay, where is Dania? Maybe that person you can, you know, say hi to me first. Is Dania here? Dania is from which LC? Yeah, pin Dania. Where is Dania? Hello, Dania, are you here?
Yeah.
Hi, good morning. Yeah, I hope that you are not playing for this restaurant. What? Okay, what? I cannot hear one. Okay, but whatever. Okay, yeah. Congratulations, Dania. You get the very first gift from Fun Team for the day 3. So yeah, you stay here first. Okay, don't go anywhere. You don't leave the group. Don't chat. You lag it to roll. Okay, yeah. Okay, you can go to the next. This one, agenda manager, okay, keep on answering useless stuff and then, you know, flooding the chat, okay, not answering the FASI and chair question properly. Like when people ask what MCP do, and then the agenda manager say do agenda manager, or what, to be pretty, and then when the chair asks what do chair do, and then the agenda manager put to sit. Okay, when fun team see this kind of thing, right, very angry lah, because it's not paying attention towards the plenary, okay, and then simply just, you know, flooding the Zoom chat lah without I mean the things that this agenda manager just say is a very useless lah. Okay, so who is the agenda manager? Everyone can type her name and then shout her name. Who is the agenda manager?
Lamin.
Yeah, it's Lamin. Yeah, yeah, everyone. Yeah, that is why. Okay, do you all think that we should punish this kind of person? Okay, yeah, not paying attention. Yeah, it's Lermin. Okay, good job, everyone. You guys remember, at least you guys remember right now, right? Who is agenda manager or who is, you know, who is MCP right now, okay? Yeah, good job. Okay, can click on next. Actually, got one cute photo lah. Can click next. Yeah, this is what your MCP do, okay, behind the scene. Okay, so cute. So funny as well. Okay, so yeah, let's go to the next. Okay, this kind of name, very obvious, still don't want to open camera, okay? Actually, a lot of people didn't open camera, lah, I know, but then it's very hard for me to, you know, screenshot everyone. I'm very tired, lah, but I only purposely catch those people who caught my attention, okay? Like, for example, even Fessy, you see this rainbow is not opening camera, yeah. Rainbow, you guys know who is the rainbow lah, okay? Rainbow and the sun and the rain, I don't know lah, whatever. And then who is Saw, huh? Okay, I think this one, I just simply saw this person name is very interesting. And then, yeah, I just screenshot lah, okay? Eventually, it turns out in the slide because, yeah, I screenshotted, okay? So who is Saw, huh? Which person is Saw, huh, here? I don't know, is this your real name? Yeah. Yeah. Anyone? I don't know. So hi, are you here? Okay, if no, then the JB chief delegate. Yeah. Who is the JB CD here? AJB.
Hello.
you all. Okay. It's okay. Okay. Next, go to the next. Yeah, you see you also in the board already lah. JB, what you guys are doing JB, always like this one, okay? And also Vivian, you're not dancing roll call because you are you caught my attention since the first day, but you're not dancing roll call in front of me, okay? Yeah, so you see, people who are not dancing roll call, huh, you know lah, huh? Okay, later on when we ask everyone open camera, dance roll call, please dance roll call, at least you shake your head, okay? Just entertain us, okay? Okay. So with that, right, what kind of punishment that we have today? Okay, so you guys can choose, right? Choose. Who wants to choose first?
I want to choose the circle.
Choose a circle. Okay, Hui is the circle. How about others?
I got a question to ask before I choosing.
Yeah.
So today, can you tell me which one is easier to do? Today you see you're so pretty, right? And then you see you're so sweet. And then do you wish to like punish me like that, man? Right.
Okay, first thing first, sorry. I think I'm younger than you. I'm only 10 years old. You don't need to call me 姐姐 or what lah. Okay, I'm very young lah. Okay, sorry. Okay, this thing will feel ready. Okay, then you have to choose. I cannot tell you which one is easy to do. You just go with your heart. What kind of the things that you like from this tree? Okay, you can just choose.
I like you the most. What?
If you like me, right, then I will actually normally I will choose triangle. Okay, so do you want to choose triangle?
Then I follow you, lor.
All right, yeah, left. Where is the rainbow and the sun? Rainbow, where are you?
Here, I'm here.
Yeah, wait, pin this person, please. Fun team chat.
You mean this person? Okay, yeah,
choose one.
Yeah, I choose umbrella. La.
You choose umbrella. Good job. Okay, left the last one. Do you want to choose for agenda manager? You guys can choose for agenda manager. We don't let agenda manager to choose because she already planned all the agenda for you. And then you don't need to choose, right? Okay, Najib, say all three. Okay.
Okay.
There's only three.
Which one you want to choose? I mean, you can choose other people one. Choose Money Lion logo for agenda manager. Good job. Wait. Choose one faster.
Triangle.
Okay. All right, let's review what is the punishment, okay? Yeah, hey, wait. Okay. So the circle one is who already? Who choose circle? No one, right?
God.
Oh,
JB line.
Yeah. Good job. What you need to do, right now, you go and find a piece of biscuit in front of the screen. Yeah, I will give you like a 10 seconds. You go in and find, okay? Yeah, you go and find in your house. Okay, so for people, for rainbow, you choose umbrella, right? Okay, you go and find 500 ml water, okay? Like one tumbler, okay? Like this. You cannot see. Sorry. Let me share you. Okay, wait. I need to remove. Okay, something like this, okay? Like 500 ml, okay? You go and find right now, okay? Yeah. And then for Arjuna, Manju, and Vivian, right? Okay, right now you go to your kitchen, you go and find sugar, and then you dig like 1 tablespoon of the sugar, yeah, and then you bring to here, okay? You and we are going to do mukbang, okay? Yeah. I give you 10 seconds, faster, 10 seconds. Sugar is no joke, okay? You don't go and find like whatever thing, okay? Faster, okay? We don't have a lot of time. You see, Agenda Major is very excited, go and find sugar. Okay, everyone will wait. Najee, seems like Najee, you are very excited to want to have, right? Do you want to try also? Like 3 of the punishment? Okay, I can put in today.
No, it's okay.
Let's not do that.
God damn it.
Okay, maybe you can also go and find, okay? At least you need to find sugar and also biscuit, okay? And then you put the sugar on top of the biscuit. Okay, go.
Thanks. Oh my God. I need to do both. Okay, fine.
Faster. 10 seconds, people. Come back. Done already, Vivian, done? Okay, good job. Fun team chow done?
One cup can, right? Can.
Cup can, yeah. Chin chan.
Bottle, I will die, bro. Later, I cannot fast you already.
It's okay, la. No one
can. You will go toilet only.
Hello, excuse me.
Hui, you done? You are the most privileged one, okay? You get your biscuit ready?
I got square size one, can I?
Square size also can. Everyone done, right? Left Najib, right? Okay, let's go everyone together, okay? Let's wait for Najib, and then you guys are going to eat in front of everyone. Yeah. Wait, why not use also one? Okay, can we add on more punishment for him? Because he is late. I only give 10 seconds, right? I think 10 seconds passed already. Lah. Yeah. Wait, where is the person? Okay, let's wait. Okay, what should we do? Let's look at Najib photo. Because his photo is like his profile picture, whatever, I don't know. Yeah. Okay, let's wait. Oh, you guys want to eat first? Okay, let's see who eat first. Who you can eat biscuit in front of us first. Yeah, everyone can see. And then you need open sound. We need to listen to ASMR, okay? Yeah. Too soft. You have to bite louder.
I'm gonna bite the louder.
Yeah, okay. Eat finish faster. Give you 3 more seconds. 3, 2, 1, yeah, good job, everyone. Clap for Hui, yay. Yeah, okay. Early morning, eat breakfast. This is your breakfast. I hope you enjoy your very dry breakfast, okay? Yeah, so let's go to the next one, okay? Yeah, Najib, you're back, right? Can I see your biscuit topped with sugar? Can you show us first? Okay, good job. Okay, so not right now, everyone, right? Okay, you guys can eat together, okay? Yeah, have to show closer to the screen like this, okay? Vivian, you have to come closer to the screen. Okay, yeah. I say 3, 2, 1, everyone need to drink together. Please unmute.
Everyone.
Yeah, you guys need to do together, okay? We need to listen to the sound, okay? Like the ASMR, yeah. Okay, in front, okay. Let's say,
sugar, no sound.
Huh?
Sugar.
You have to make it got sound like something like that. Okay, if you drink water, then you have to drink out the water sound like
something like that. Okay, whatever you just try your way. You need to be solution oriented. We are leaders, right? Okay, we have to, you know, like show lead by example. Okay, yeah. Okay, so wait, unmute Lola.
Oh my god. Okay, sorry.
Okay, yeah. So 3, 2, 1, one shot it finish Woohoo! Wait, rainbow so slow. Najee, faster.
Oh.
Is it nice, the people who eat sugar? How do you feel?
The sugar is flying everywhere.
I like sweet stuff.
Good. Okay, Rainbow, do you drink finish? You have to talk like this, give us to see.
Wow.
Are you still okay? Yeah. Fake, oh. Rainbow, you fake, huh? Okay. Yeah, I think that's all. Okay, thank you everyone for participating in my morning games. Okay, yeah, these people, remember, I will be catching you for whole day. Okay, make sure that you open your cam, lunch roll call, and then don't simply answer those useless stuff in the chat box. Okay, yeah, so that's all from me. Yeah, before that, right, remember, okay, today is the last day, so let fun team do more job. Okay, we are looking forward, especially for Love Wine now. Okay, tonight we will have more spicy stuff, like, okay, in the closing panel, so make sure that you submit let's say if you want to match with someone. Okay, yeah, everyone is waiting. You can see Punisher and Dr. Love is waiting already. So that's all from me. Bye everyone.
Thank you. Bye, Fanti. Thank you, ETA. You guys are so creative with the punishment. Like, I cannot imagine me like eating the whole spoon of sugar, even though I like sweet so much. So yeah, everyone remember to submit your Dr. Love sipping because tonight is the only chance that you get to sip your friends. So make sure that your friends no longer single after the conference. So yes, let us welcome Lamin, the agenda manager of this conference.
Good morning, everyone. Yeah, so yeah, today is the last day of the conference. It's the last time. No, it's not the last time I meet you. I will meet you physically in the next conference because you are going to apply team leader in very soon. Okay. So day three agenda. So for today, we were talking a lot about yourself, understanding yourself, and also how to get to know yourself better and also get to know yourself more, because I see in day one, feedback form, right? In either essence, why we do what we do sessions. A lot of you mentions about you like the sessions that able to let you to understand and explore more about yourself. So here come your need and your wish, which is on your journey on the last day. So we will have, we are right now in morning plenary, and then after that we'll have a series of either value sessions that aim for you to know better. And also how to uphold the value in your daily life, and also what do we mean by everyone behind the value. So for here, right, just want to emphasize again. So there are two part of the sessions, and the registration form is already sent out yesterday, and we close at 8, and the delegate name list we already collected. So you can see I already released the part one of the name list, which is activating leadership, living diversity, and also demonstrating integrity, the first part of the name list in the delegate broadcast group. So you can just check it for the first part. And then during lunchtime, I will release the second part. So to avoid any confusions, then you will like be like, oh, so many name lists, which one should I look at? So that's why I only release the part one. So you can refer to the delegate broadcast. And then after all the 6 ISA value, we will have one external sessions with our strategic partner. She will be coming over to talk about how to utilize the community report, the report that you received at first, and how to utilize it to understand more about yourself. And then with after that, we will have one very important session talking about our entity stand and also our entity vision, which is ISA in Malaysia Wish Towards Malaysia, so which is for a United Malaysia sessions by Anderson, the LCP of in our FESI team. And then we will have a closing plenary to end our conference and also to end our day. So basically, this is what you will be going through on day 3. So make sure you do not miss any sessions because I think today's sessions will be more fun than yesterday. Yeah, okay. So, yeah, that's all. I will pass it back to chair.
Thank you so much, Lamine. Yep. So, yeah, I believe everyone has already have a clear picture of what we are going to do today. So, yeah, let me share the screen again. So yesterday, conference objective is about ownership, like to own your journey. And this journey here, I think to me personally, it's not only about your Isaac experience, but it's also applied to your personal life. Yeah. So today, the conference behavior that I want you to embrace is embrace my Isaac journey, embrace your own Isaac journey, and understand your role and your goal in Isaac and also in your personal life, and also be brave in taking ownership of your own decision and the experience that you are going to have. So mainly it's about you taking the ownership of both of your Isaac life and also your personal life. And then as you already know that my role as a chair in this conference is to share and connect story with everyone, right? So today I will share you about my first love. I think I take quite a long time to decide whether I should say about this story to you guys or not. But since today it's about ownership, and I think this story have a very powerful, it's very powerful to me because it changed my life. Like it changed how I see my life as a person. So I think it's very, very relevant to you, especially like for people who just like 18, 19, right? So yeah, my first love is not something that you would expect as a like love life or something, but I want to dedicate this story to my father, my dad. So I told you guys that I was born in Thailand, right? So this picture is also was taken in Thailand when I was just born, I think a few months only. You can see how small I am and how happy my dad is back then. And when I was born, I think my dad was 56 years old. So it was quite I think the age gap between me and my dad is very big. Like to me, among my friend, I think my dad is the oldest one. And he loved me so much because my biggest sister, like my big JJ, she's like 15 years older than me. So they thought they're only going to have only one daughter, but then 15 years later, I arrived. So yeah, so they loved me so much and they named me Jen. So I think this is what I mean to my family, especially to my father, because he always loved daughter loves to have a lot of children, but they didn't get the chance to help me as early as they expected. So yeah. And I think in the world, right, I think I love my father the most. I think I love him the most because he is the person who saved me to be who I am today. He shared me a lot of life lesson that I would say that make me realize like how I should live my life as a person, right? We was not rich when I was born. Like I would say we are quite poor. Like I what I know from this that they didn't even have the money to buy me like meal. So I only drink like the porridge water. So I was very, very skinny when I was young. And my dad was a baker, so he did a lot of good bread and cake. So yeah, I think he made the best dessert, the best cake, but I don't really get to eat a lot of them. Not only that, he also the one who showed me how to love, to care, and to support the people around me. And I learned from that because of the action that he take, like the make he act to the family, right? One thing that I remember the most when I was young is that my dad was a Chinese, so he didn't really speak good Khmer. But in order for me to get the education, he registered me for Khmer class when I was 10, but he didn't know how to write Khmer letter, right? And in Cambodia, in order for you to buy like books to enter the class, he asked the teacher to write down all the name of the Khmer books on a paper, and then he go and hand it to the bookseller without like knowing what's on the paper, without knowing how to pronounce the title of the books, the textbook that I need to buy to study in the class. So to me, it was very, I think like that was one of the most memorable memory that I have as a kid, even though my dad didn't really like understand my letter, but he really put so much effort in make sure that I can get the books and can get to study in the Khmer class. The way he showed me how to love is he remembered everything about me. I think one special thing about my family is that we celebrate every birthday together. So he remembered my birthday even like clearer than his own birthday. And no matter how busy he is, he always makes sure to buy me a cake. So I think I'm spoiled when my friend don't buy me cake or don't remember my birthday, I would be very upset, because I think the way I grow up is like my father always remember like my birthday. And he also remember every favorite food that I like. So I think it's also go the same to your family, right? When you tell your parents, I like durian, then in order to make you happy, they would buy durian for the whole week. So until you don't want to eat durian anymore. I think that's how my dad spoiled me. And to care, I think even though he doesn't have much, but I have everything that I needed in life. I didn't even ask for a lot of material things like iPhone, like a laptop or money, but he made sure that he can provide me everything that I need by the age. Yeah. And to me, he's my first love. He was the first person who showed me how to love and then who teach me how to love. And he was the only motivation in my life back then. I think the only thing that I wanted was to make him happy. So I study very hard. Like I get a lot of scholarship in order to like save money for him, because I know he doesn't have much. And I spend a lot of time staying with him, like reading newspaper every morning, sharing about zodiac, because and also our like Chinese zodiac, and also our habits. So my dad can write really good letters, so we also spend a lot of time practicing our like writing. But unfortunately, in 2017, on a very busy Sunday, I lost him forever to his long-term illness, I would say. So that time it was very, I would say, unexpected, because we didn't expect like to lose him in a like on a random like Sunday holiday, right? And on that day, I didn't even manage to say goodbye to him, because I was in the province doing my work. Yeah, by the time I get home, he's already like very like serious, so I didn't manage to go to in the ambulance with him. Yeah, I was the only one who didn't get to say goodbye to my father in the family. And I think since he was the only motivation for me to study very hard, to try to earn a lot of money, the time that I lost him, I also lost myself. I think I have a very mixed feeling back then, because just like I said, like he's old and he have a lot of illness with him. Like he has diabetes, he has high blood pressure, but it was expected that one day he's going to leave us, like maybe earlier than what my friends experienced in life. But nothing has prepared me for the loss, especially when I was not home, like on the day that I was not home. So I think after that, I spent around 1 year like pretending that everything was all right. I was in a denial state, like I didn't want to come home because usually when I come home, people would wait for me at the dinner table, but I didn't want to come home at night because I know like there's no longer like someone waiting for me at the sofa in the living room, waiting for me to like have dinner with him. So I spent a lot of time outside in that year, and I didn't want to be home and then accept the fact that he's no longer there for me. And I think one of the most worst thing that I do back then was also like throwing anger or blame to the people around me. I blame the healthcare system in Cambodia. Why didn't they manage to save my dad? I blame my sister for not taking care enough of him when he was there. I blame myself for not staying home on that day. And it was a lot of regret. Like sometimes he would ask me to go, oh, have a haircut with him. But then I was too busy hanging out with my friend. Then I didn't manage to spend his time. So when I lost him, I sometimes think if on that day I go to spend more time with him, maybe just 1 or 2 hours, have some meaningful conversation with him, then maybe it would make him very happy. And then, or maybe after I come from work, I buy him favorite food, that would also like make him happy. So it's all the guilt feeling that I have toward myself. And it was very, I think it was the darkest moment in my life. So I was very lost. And in that year also in 2018, I was in my last year of university, but because by the time my dad passed away, I was having a big exam in my university, so I didn't manage to do it well, so I lost my motivation in study also. So I decided to suspend my study in year 4, and I don't know what to do, so I just applied for a random job doing marketing full time. And I think on a monthly one-to-one coaching with my manager back then in the company, I received one question from her. She didn't know what I've been through. I think we only know each other for around like 3 months back then. But there's one question that triggered me so much. Like she asked me, what do I want in life? Because I was very new to the company, right? So normally in corporate or in ISAC, they would as the team leader to do coaching or mentoring with their team member. So this is the question that she asked me, and she didn't expect me to like react in that way. So when I know that question, I answer like, I honestly didn't know what I want. I don't know what I want. I tell her honestly, like I just randomly applied for a job because I thought I need money or I need something to keep me busy. And I don't know what I want to do in life. I don't know who I want to become, because the only motivation back then was my dad, and now I lost him. So I don't know like what should I do to make people around me happy. So I depends a lot on, I think I would bet my happiness on the people around me, especially my dad, rather than put it on myself. So I have a very negative thought back then, like after a few time of speaking to her, right? Because you know, like, okay, I think she noticed like I have this kind of problem in life as a adult, like don't know what to do, and then I even suspend my class. So she chat to me a lot, like asking how I am, blah blah blah. And then this is what I thought, and this is what I tell her, like I don't know what's missing in my life, like I just don't feel happy, and I don't think I can change anything about it, because like it's that, like you cannot ask one person to come back to life, right? So I don't know what can I do to change that situation or to change my mindset back then. But I was very grateful that she didn't give up on me. I think she spent around almost a year trying to talk to me, trying to get to know more about me. And one thing that she, I think this is what she told me when I really like feel like I own this person too much, and this person care about me even more than I do to myself back then. She said like I should really think about what I want in life and actually take the ownership of my life to be the happy girl that I used to be when my dad was there, and give myself one more chance that I can change everything. It's not as bad as I thought, right? And she said that I'm actually a very strong person. I didn't cry a lot when I lost my dad, and I managed to find a job. I managed to still live my life. It's just I don't really show people that I was lost. And she told me that I'm more than just my struggle. I'm more than just my negative thoughts. And I think that message is powerful, because sometimes I would think that I'm very weak and didn't believe in my ability in like living my own life. All the negative thoughts make me make me drown, I would say. I was keep making excuses that, oh, I cannot be happy. This is it. Like, I'm just going to spend the rest of my life in this way. And I also blame others a lot on the circumstance that happened because of my own decision. So I think easy example, like if I was late to the meeting, I would blame it on the traffic jam. I wouldn't blame myself for being late, for not being prepared, for not doing good in time management. So I become a very like self-victimized person back then, because I thought everything in life was bad. Why is this happening to me, right? But what I learned from that conversation that I had with him for almost the whole year, right? I started to realize back that maybe what she said was right. I'm more than just the bad thoughts. Maybe I have some good potential. Maybe I have some dream that I want to achieve as a person also. That as an adult, I should take accountability for my own feeling. It's okay for me to feel sad, to feel doubt, but I shouldn't blame myself for that. I think taking accountability of my own feeling is totally different from me say casting to myself, blaming myself or being guilty for the loss. And I started to learn to be honest to myself that okay, on a special anniversary or on my father's birthday, I would feel extra sadder than on a usual day, and I accept that feeling. And I acknowledge that it become a trauma for me. And I'm willing to work in order to heal from that. I'm no longer in denial, because I think if I still stuck in that denial state, I will also lose my time or lose my quality time with the remaining family member, right? So I still have my sibling, I still have my dogs, I still have my dog that I love, like my sons. I didn't manage to spend a lot of time with them if I was still in that denial state. So during that time also, I came across a Facebook post and also a TED talk about grieving. What they said in that grieving is, I think it's really true to me, because a lot of people try to tell me, oh, I should move on. I think this happened a lot in life, right? Someone's going to leave you in one day. You just haven't prepared for it, especially it's your parent. But to me, I will never move on. The fact that I am trying to be very honest with myself. And what happened is that I just learned to live with it. I just learned to live with the fact that I'm grieving for the loss of my parent, and I will not move on from it. I will just learn how to live with it, and I carry it with my life and to take it as a lesson. Yeah. And I think the key things I learned is also like, I was giving away my power, and I was giving away my control of the life to other people and to the external factor. Like, I blame it on the people who make me feel angry. I blame it on the people who make me feel sad. But actually, I should be the one who takes charge in my life and determine the way that I think or I feel or I live. Because I don't think anyone can decide it for me. And I also being very open after that. I think I'm the kind of person who express a lot of my feelings. So randomly, I just send my manager this message as a appreciation for her to help me go through that stage of my life. And also just want to thank her for not giving up on me, even though I spent a long time, like almost 1 year, in order for me to be open up about her and then have this kind of realization. And my current goal in life is to have freedom. I think I shared this to Fasit team also. And the freedom that I wanted in life is come from knowing that I have choice. And I'm the only one who hold the power to choose how I want to live my life. So what make me happy every day is that I get to design my own life. I choose the way I want to live. I choose my career. I choose what food I eat. I choose who I want to be with. I choose who I want to talk to. Whether it make me sad or whether it make me angry, it's me deciding how to react to those circumstances. And to me, talking about ownership is taking 100% responsibility for what's going on with my life. And I love spending time in vision a life that I desire most. And I also take take the charge of my own happiness. And I'm proud of my decision, whether I will regret it later or not. But I think I make that decision in that specific time because I was conscious. Like, I think it's also applied to my diet process. I told you I managed to lose 11 kilogram like last year after I finished Isaac, right? So it was me who chose what to eat. Example, if I choose to eat like very unhealthy food like pizza, then I know, okay, this is the day that I allow myself to eat something that's really good in terms of taste, but tomorrow I will not do it again. And I'm taking, like, I'm being very honest with me and I'm making that decision consciously. It's no longer like me when I was young, like I eat whatever I want. I don't care about whatever outcome I will have. So this also apply in, and I think it's applied in every aspect of my life. So yeah, I spend a lot of time thinking about what I want to achieve, what I want to experience, and what I want to choose. And I own those decisions. So I think what makes me stand out currently as someone who just going to work full time after I say, right, I think if you ask me what's my goal in the next 3 years, what's my goal in the next 10 years, or what do I want to, how do I envision my life when I was 15 years, when I am 50 years old, I can tell you like very clear on what I want. So it's no longer a lost mission back then. And I'm sharing this story because I feel like I learned this lesson about ownership in the hardest way. And I don't want anyone to go through this in order to learn about this. This is why I'm bringing up this very personal story to you guys here, because I know like if you can learn about ownership in an easier way, then maybe I should be the one who provide you, like who share you this story, so you don't have to go through the same shit like me. And this is also the wallpaper on my phone. It's a daily reminder for me to choose how to react to external factor. So I was very aggressive before, but now I'm no longer that aggressive. I would say I would think very careful on how I reacted to stuff. And I think this is a very good reminder to me as a person. And the powerful message that I tell myself every day is that whatever happened, it's all up to me. Like it's me who choose that. So I should not feel any like regret about it. So yeah, I just want you to enjoy the last day of the conference and design your own life. I want you to really think about it. Like, what do you want in the future? Because taking ownership is believing that all happened in your life is all up to you. Whether you have a good experience in Isaac or a bad one, or you don't like your team, or your team is a very good people to be with, like it's all up to you. It's how you give and take in that situation and how you choose to react. So yeah, I want you to spend some time in the breakout room. So maybe since we don't have much time, Liwei, can we have only 3 people in the breakout room? And then we have like 5 minutes for them to share. So I want you to spend some time to think about what would your best life look like and what is holding you back? Is it the task is you, is it a trauma, or is it someone in your life that keep saying no to you? What's that? Like, what is holding you back? So yeah, make sure that everyone gets to talk, and then I also want to hear your sharing when you're back. Welcome back. Do you guys have enough time to share? If not, I think you can keep this question to I think maybe after conference, like really spend some time to think about it. So yeah, I also want to hear about what do you want to do in life, right? So if you want to share, you can raise your hand. Okay, very fast. We have Peanut here. Peanut.
No, hi. Hi, my name is Peanut. Again. Actually, I have a very similar situation as MG, because yeah, my father also recently passed away, and I'm one of the closest person to my father. So since he was passed away, so it's been a very hard time for me. Yeah, it also takes me a year to cope with that, to accept all the things that happened. And yeah, soon after my father passed away, I have to live abroad, and I have to deal with all these things alone. And yeah, it didn't go really well actually. But after that, it's like I soon realized that I am kind of glad I've been through everything, all of this, because you know, it's changed my life, and I become a different person than I was before. So it's kind of not answering the question. So I kind of get back to the question. So it's actually, I want to relate that to the first thing, like what I think best for my life is actually the freedom to choose. I've been living for more than 20 years. I've been living in the life where everything, like going into with the flow, I don't have anything to choose. Like I don't have dreams. I don't even know where I want to be. I don't even know what to choose. And eventually I started to forget about it. And I even forget how to choose. It's like you go on to your dream, your day, like you're living in a cage, and whenever the cage open, you have only one road. And imagine that road has no junction, no traffic light. It's just a road with no ending. Yeah. The person who actually get this to me is actually, I thought at first is the people around me. That's why I've been living like, I keep distancing myself from around all the people, like from my parents, from my best friends, and all the people that actually care for me. So, but soon after that, I realized that the one who keep me living like this is not them. It's actually me. Me is preventing myself from choosing. It's like me make this own rule for me to live in this way. So yeah. But thank God, now I realize about this, and now I have a freedom to choose again. So yeah.
Thank you
for listening. Yeah. That is awkward.
No. Sad, huh? I wish I could help you. Yeah, thank you so much for being open and share us this very meaningful story about you. So talk to me whenever you need any support on that, right? You know. Thank you, Peanut. So I think next we can have Amanda, and then after Amanda we can have Suwei. I also would like to say sorry to the rest of the people who raised their hand, because there are so many people raised their hand, but I'm a bit late in terms of time. So yeah, you can also feel free to share in the chat box. Yep. So yes, Amanda, you can have your space.
Ah, all right. So, oh my God, this session teared me up so much. Okay. So, what do my best life look like? So, to be honest, I don't have a clear example for that, but probably happiness. But I think we as person, we won't be able to like find happiness every day, because it's just life strikes us very much, like things, shits happen in our life. And again, to be honest, I am not very clear about it. Like, I don't know how will my best life look like. And that's the problem, you know, like, that's the issue, and kind of sound depressing, but yeah, like I will actually wake up every day talking to myself, like, what are you doing in this world? Like, you're only lying on your bed and do some unnecessary things. Like, your other friends are being so productive. Like, are you not insecure about it? Like, all about insecurity. And what or who is actually holding me back is actually myself. Like, because the bad guy who is actually in my life is actually myself, because I, you know, those words that saying that you're actually the bad guy of your own life. Yeah, I think I felt that. So yeah, I think, yeah, this session makes me want to explore more about myself, and then you know, taking ownership of my life. Yeah, thank you guys. Oh, that sounds depressing, but thank you.
Thank you, Amanda, for sharing. I think this is probably one of the most valuable realization you can have from this conference, and I hope you keep this thought and keep exploring about it. So yeah, next we have Zhiwei.
All right. So hello everyone. Yeah. So to me, actually, my best life, I'm still figuring out, but then I actually got inspired by the sharing just now, and I think that my best life would be like, I am there to like choose and be responsible to my decision. And because, to be honest, I am a person that maybe I feel like everything there is right and wrong, and then I think I'm living in a square where I scared that I choose this thing and I make this decision and it is wrong, and I like maybe tend to follow people to go to the correct direction, and I don't dare to like maybe do the things that I really want. Yeah, I scared that it is wrong or what. So I think that would be freedom to, and also be responsible. I have the courage to be responsible to the decision I make. Oh yeah, in future, hopefully I can do so. Yeah, and the things that actually that hold me back is would be myself. Like, my own thoughts are like, I think same like Peanut, like, because I'm a person that kind of overthink, and also I tend to shut myself down, like away from people, like not wanting people to help me out, yeah, due to some reason. Yeah, I think that it's myself that is holding me back, yeah, and should try to open myself and don't overthink too much. Yeah, that is all for me. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you so much, Wei. I think you and Amanda sharing is really, I think to me, it's make me feel very happy as a child who want to share you the story. Like, because by the end, you share that the person that's holding you back is yourself. I think this is the first step of taking ownership already. So congratulations to you guys for like realizing about this, and hopefully, taking ownership of your own life can make you a lot happier than now. Yes. Thank you. Of course, this is not going to end here. I mean, like the story that we share, you still can approach me and talk to me anytime with Telegram or IG or whatever. One last message again. So yeah, spend some time to really think about it and then design your own life. You plan it out and then make sure that all the decision is chosen by you. So yeah, on the last day, I wish you could design and live your best life and always be proud of your own decision. So yeah, we have one final OC announcement for today. So can we have the OC here? Yeah, OC, please try to make please try to be very funny. I think everyone is crying right now. I didn't want it to happen actually.
Okay. Next slide, please. Okay. So what OC have for you is the merchandise corner. So yeah, don't be sad. Buy merchandise for your friend. Yeah, make them happy. So if you want to buy them, don't buy, just buy them lah. Or stickers, make them happy lah. So in the next slide is, next slide please. Yeah, so digital postcard. So you can write something or, oh, you did a great job. Don't be discouraged or like, you're doing great. So you write in the digital postcard and you send to the, and then send keychain. And then last but not least, is the t-shirt. So yeah, this is for merchandise corner. So if you move on to the next page, so if you want to buy them or like buy for yourself, so you can scan the QR code here. And then my OC already sent me the send the merchandise link in the group so you can go and buy. Yeah, okay. And then next is conference challenges. So far we received 23 out of 24 tribal group who have already started. So the one more tribal group who haven't started, you know lah who you are. So if you want to have more fun, then you should gather your tribal groups and play all the conference challenges. Yeah, and also win awesome prizes. Okay, the next one please. Yeah, the next one is Sugar Cube. So if you just now, it was very sad, right? It's okay. You can also send Sugar Cube to them, like using the Saraha link, send to the, it can be anonymous also, or if you want to tell them, oh, it's me, then you just put your name under the, in the Saraha message. Yeah, just send them all your love. Yes. And if you want to find like any of the link, like the Saraha link or the merchandise one, you can use the link tree or the, use the Delegate Mastership. Everything is in there already. We also, we put everything in there for you because we love you. Yeah. And then, yeah. Okay, that's all from OC.
Yeah, thank you, Suwanna. Nice marketing skill. I think you can work in marketing in the future, or maybe sales, convincing people to buy unlimited happiness by purchasing the merchandise. I just want to also promote for the OC because I think I love collecting my Isaac stuff, especially t-shirt. I'm still wearing t-shirt, like Isaac t-shirt to work. So yeah, make sure to get yours. Yeah, so one fun fact that I share about my story and I turn off my camera because I don't want to look funny and like distract you guys from crying. That's why I turn off my camera. See, whenever I show my face funny. Yeah, so that's it for me in the morning plenary. See you in the closing plenary, also the last session of today. Enjoy your day. Bye bye.
Thank you. Bye bye.
Yeah, Lamine, do you have any announcement?
Yes. So you can refer to the broadcast, Delegate broadcast channel. So you can find the room, the Isaac value that you sign up for. So for those who didn't manage to sign up yesterday, which means you cannot find your name in any of the room, please only join Living Diversity and Demonstrating Integrity, because we have too many delegates in activating leadership. So please only join Demonstrating Integrity and Living Diversity. And then for activating leadership, you just remain in this room. You no need to change room, okay? Only Living Diversity and Demonstrating Integrity, you will need to change your room, and the Zoom link you can find in the broadcast channel. Yep. So you will have break right now until 11:30. Plus, please join back the Zoom link at 11:25 so that we can start on time at 11:30. Okay, remind your tribe mate, remind your friends, remind your LCP to join in on time at 11:25. Then we will start at 11:30 sharp. Thank you,
Amin. Yeah, go invite your tier people. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye, everyone.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye. 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 Bye-bye.